Capitals come home, grab a lead and hold off the Islanders, 4-3. Returning to Washington after a long trip through Western Canada, the Capitals considered a formula for improving their miserable record at home. Probably score a little bit more, coach Barry Trotz suggested before the puck dropped Thursday against the New York Islanders at Capital One Arena. And so on Thursday night against the New York Islanders, the Capitals scored the first goal. Trotz particularly wanted to see more secondary scoring, with goals coming from the third and fourth lines. The Capitals got that, too, scoring their most goals at home since the opener a month ago, and it all resulted in a 4-3 win. As Washington has come back to the pack in the Metropolitan Division, its record hovering around .500, this game carried particular importance, in part because it represented an opportunity for the Capitals to re-establish their home ice as an advantage after just one win in their first four games in Chinatown. Anders Lee's goal 7 minutes into the third period drew the Islanders even at 3, but with 3:21 remaining, third-line center Lars Eller scored his second goal of the game on an odd-man rush with Tom Wilson. Trotz's call for production from the bottom two lines was answered with 3 goals with the third line on the ice and 1 from the fourth line. Entering Thursday night's game, Washington had gotten just 6 goals through 12 games from its bottom two lines, and Christian Jews's 2 goals marked the only production from the defenseman. But the Capitals heard the home crowd loud and clear late in the second period, when 12 seconds after the Islanders tied the game with a power play goal by Lee, Alex Chiasson fired a laser of a slap shot past Islanders goaltender Jaroslav Halak to give Washington back its 1-goal lead. A deep and balanced lineup was a strength of the Capitals last year as they rolled to the league's best regular season record. But salary cap constraints this summer led to off-season roster turnover. That, coupled with injuries to the core of forwards, has been a hit to Washington's offense. Chiasson is the newest face to the team, joining the team in training camp on a professional tryout before earning a contract. The Capitals hoped his 12 goals last season were a sign of things to come as a secondary scorer this season. His goal against the Islanders marked his first of the season. The Capitals' first goal of the game also came from an unexpected source. With Washington's third line on the ice and creating traffic in front of Halak, defenseman Taylor Trenny's shot from the point glided into the netting 5:55 into the game, just the 4th goal of Chorny's career in his 150th NHL game. That also broke a 7-game streak of Washington allowing the first goal. After defenseman Brooks Orpik was called for slashing 12:55 into the first period, the Islanders scored just 6 seconds into their power play, with captain John Tavares whacking at a puck in front until it slipped through Braden Holtby's legs. Eller scored with a slap shot in front less than 4 minutes later to put Washington ahead again before a first intermission. Forward Chandler Stevenson, called up last week because of injuries, scored the first 2 assists of his NHL career, setting up both Eller and Chorny's goals. Earlier in the week, Trotz lamented the few power play opportunities Washington was getting, which was mostly due to the Capitals struggling to play with the puck for long stretches. But while the Capitals had 3 power plays in the first 40 minutes, 2 penalties were drawn by Eller, the man advantage couldn't convert on the opportunities. Meanwhile, the Islanders scored 2 goals on their first 3 power plays, with Washington's penalty kills still a concern. The Capitals have allowed at least 1 power play goal in 8 games, and this was the team's 4th game surrendering at least 2 power play goals. But Washington always had an answer for New York, getting its home turf rocky.